All right. So, a little bit of technical difficulties. I think I got it now. I don't know if you can see this. I'm literally about to look at it. But, so, for my demo, I'm going to do the airbag experiment. It's simple, but it would have been simple if I could steal an airbag from a car, but it's a liability, so I can't really do that. So I'm doing this. So it's supposed to go over the ideal gas law and how we use this to figure out the modes of CO2 produced and how the reaction undergoes an exothermic reaction, basically, where the airbag is supposed to expand and it's supposed to cushion the person from getting injured when they are in impact of a car accident. I think I explained that right. Yeah. So, ideal gas law, the equation we're going to use is PV equals NRT, where our P is the atmospheric pressure, so it's 1 atm. Our volume is the Ziploc bag we're using, which is 3.78 liters. Solving for N, so this would be our moles of CO2 produced, with R is really the ideal gas constant, which is about 0.0821, and our temperature is about 293 Kelvin, because that's the temperature right now. And so our materials is to put back the moles of 6 moles of acetic acid with baking soda and about a graduated cylinder just to measure. And then this is the equation that's plugged in. So you have 1 atm times your volume equals moles times your R times your T, and then N is equals to 0.157 moles. Yeah, of CO2. Sorry, I haven't done one of these since graduation. Yeah, that was awkward, because graduating via webcam wasn't fun. But, you know, here we are. So, basically, when we find our moles of CO2, we're going to figure out the liters that are going to be used for acetic acid and the grams that we're going to use for baking soda. So the molar mass of baking soda is 84.007 grams per mole, and our molarity per liter is 6 moles per liter for the acetic acid. So in short, we're going to use moles of CO2 divided by moles of acetic acid. So it's going to be 0.157 divided by 6 equals about 0.0261 liters, times that by 1,000 equals 26.1 milliliters. Same is done for baking soda. You're going to use the moles of CO2 multiplied by the molar mass of baking soda. So your 0.157 is times 84.007 grams, and that gives us about 13.18 grams of baking soda that we're using. Yeah. Sounds good. All right, let's start the experiment. So for the experiment, we're basically going to put the baking soda in one side and then the acetic acid in the other, and then try to make sure no other air gets in here. And then once they're combined, we're going to mix them together, and that's how the expansion of the air is going to produce the CO2 and the water within, and it's going to inflate it like an airbag. And yeah, if all goes well, I will be able to pop this, because why not? So let's see. We got the baking soda on this side. If you see it, looks like a certain powder. But this is
for legal reasons, be consumed. No reason should it be. So we're going to put it on one side. Would have music, but I'm not that tech savvy, so I can't really do music. There we go. I'm trying to make sure it stays in one side or corner. That way it doesn't, like so. Yeah. And then on this other side, we're going to fold it and put the acetic acid in here. That way when we combine them, it mixes together and fools me. And let's see if we're going to. I should put like music in this time. It feels very awkward. But you know, if you don't know, acetic acid is basically vinegar. And it is success. No mixing over. Hopefully, we're trying to make sure it drains out everything. Wish I had a lab partner that will take this cylinder out of my hand before I drop it. Fun fact, I am the most clumsiest person. I have managed to drop so many beakers. And yet, they have not broken. For some reason, well, I know the reason why, but acetic acid smells like salt and vinegar chips. And I like those. People don't like them. I don't know. They're pretty good. So I'm going to try to get all the air out before I move on to this next part. I'm trying my best not to mix it. And then once that is done, we just go and mix the two. It starts to increase, well, the bag is starting to inflate more. I'm trying to do more mixing. It's not that bad. Yeah. See, if this was an actual airbag, I would use my brother and do a prank on him, but again, liability, so fun. But here's this wish list of, is it wish? Yeah, wish size bag of, yeah, I don't know. Is this still recording? I would have been so mad if it wasn't recording. Yeah, so here's this. Looks pretty well. I mean, as you can tell, it's like, see, I tell you, I'm clumsy. But, yeah, from it being empty with almost no air in it to just inflating, this is, and right now for actually, yeah, it's pretty cold, so it produces the exothermic reaction of, well, yeah, releasing all the heat on the whole chemical reaction. If you feel it, it's pretty much colder. But that's my demo. I don't know what else to talk about, so yeah, hope you enjoy it.